All right, today we're going to talk about Amazon Web Services and how you can get an Amazon Cloud connection direct to your office from Fiber Internet Center. And we're the only ones that I know that do this, where we could do it in increments of megabits per second for the connection that you'd like to have. So here we go. Amazon Web Services, commonly referred to as AWS, and you can go to aws.amazon.com and learn all about the services available there. Basically, they have the Amazon Cloud. Actually, there's lots of clouds. It's a whole sky of clouds. We're just going to talk about our first connection to the cloud here. The way this works is, let's say these are in your office. Okay, so this is your office right here. And what Fiber Internet Center does is, on the router that we provide you transit with — you don't have to get our transit, as a lot of you know, you can buy transit from other companies too, AboveNet, Sprint, AT&T, Cogent, whoever you like to, Hurricane Electric, whoever you'd like to get your transit from. All right? And we bring that into your office, but what's really unique is we give the Amazon Web Services their own separate port in your office. And for those of you who have Amazon Web Services, you might notice that there's a way for you in the control panel. So when you log in at aws.amazon.com, you'll actually discover that when you sign up for the service, a control panel, and there's all kinds of resources on this control panel available to you. You could set up a server, make it run Red Hat, for instance, and set that up to be your MySQL server or MySQL server or whatever you'd like. Or you could then do the same thing with a Windows or whatever type of stuff you pick. You could set up a mail server. You could configure an HTML server. You can configure some kind of a streaming server. You can put all of these servers together. And then using this resource setup there, you can configure each one of those servers to have an IP address on its back side. So let's pretend the server — it's a virtual server to begin with, right? So pretend it's got two Ethernet ports, one that sends stuff out to people into the internet, which you can control and turn off if you want to, and then another one where you can assign it an IP address, say maybe even a 10.0 or a 192 or 172 that's not routable on the internet through internet routers. Makes your server really secure to be able to access it this way. So using the control panel that they have, you can configure your IP resources. You can configure IP addresses for all the different ones that you configure there, and you could set them up with a /24 or whatever you like. And then we bring it to you and put it on a port. What's really cool about this is we don't necessarily need to know what IP addresses you've configured for those resources. You configure them and we can run for you, or you could run it yourself at your office at great expense. You can go and buy the BGP router required, put it over here and connect it to this port, and then connect that to your LAN if you so desire. Or we can do that for you as part of our service. It's very inexpensive to have us run a BGP router and maintain it for you. When you tell the Amazon Cloud what your IP address resources are, say 10.0.0.0/24, and then you assign them to all of your different servers, say your HTML server, you go ahead and you give that one .2, and your MySQL server, you give it a .3, you give your streaming server a different one, and your mail server a different one, and you can set all of those up to be whatever you like, .4, .5 of this 10. But what's really cool is that Amazon, once those services are set up and you configure them for configure the devices for your IP resources, they configure a BGP session and they send you those IP addresses back to the BGP router. And then the BGP router, we provide you some ports that enable you on here. We carry this all the way back to your office. That in this scenario, we're going to scrape that one out here, but we carry this all the way back to your office for you. And by doing that, you now can control those IP addresses and then which IP addresses in your office you'd like to configure to be able to access those devices. So it can be a completely private cloud connection for you if you're running a virtual desktop on Microsoft's image that you could select or whatever you'd like. You can run all of that back to your office and you've got your own virtual cloud connection. Part of what we did here that I erased enables us to create for you more than one connection to the cloud. For example, in California, you can have a connection in Silicon Valley, and you can also have an AWS connection in, say, the Los Angeles area to the cloud there. And we can configure you at Fiber Internet Center to have two of those. So here's your BGP router number two. And we can also carry that to your office on another port. Or we can configure it so that one's a backup for the other. And these IP addresses will actually appear on both, in both cloud accesses and on the routers at the same time. They'll both get them, which is pretty cool and flexible for you and offers you some redundancy. So it's not just a connection to the cloud for the services that you need in your office right away. It's also a redundant connection if you'd like it to be. And based on that, you can now go ahead in your office and say you've got some stuff that runs on a Macintosh computer. Well, they don't have an image for the Mac in the Amazon cloud, but you need some services or some things that run on a Mac in order to work and interact with your stuff in the cloud. Well, now you can do that through the Mac in your office. You can have the Mac in your office maybe doing some graphics rendering or something like that that Macs are great at. And you could render these pictures and send them to the cloud, and at the same time somebody can be from the internet sending something to your server, your HTML server, and then they want it to be rendered, say put a frame around a picture, and basically your Mac receives that file, renders it up, and then sends it back to the cloud in that resource for the person to download later or send it to that person. So there's a lot of flexibility when you get directly connected to a cloud. The Fiber Internet Center, we can connect you to clouds, your own private clouds that you may have that you have at racks at data centers. We're really flexible and we can get you connections to anything. But what's really cool is, take a look at that, Amazon's control panel. There it is. Now you can see the control panel. You can go ahead and add all kinds of resources, and there's different servers there, and you can even configure what IP addresses you want your resources to have, and Amazon reannounces those to you back in this BGP session. So we've taken all the complexity and that cost of getting that service to your office, and we cut it down a great deal. I mean, it's like cut to about a third of what you would normally expect to spend to connect to the Amazon cloud. Look for the link on our homepage, fiberinternetcenter.com, that says Network Tools, and you can find a lot of links to other tools, videos, other helpful information, do some pings and trace routes around the world, and a bunch of other servers on the planet that'll help you diagnose your problems on the internet. Thank you.